What is happening, guys? Gary Jahman here, back at it again with a new video. Hope you're doing well, hope you're safe and happy. So this video is all about this Canon PowerShot SX740HS. The Canon PowerShot SX740HS is a compact camera or a point-and-shoot camera with some pretty cool specs. It has 40x optical zoom, and this range is pretty sweet, from 24 millimeters all the way up to 960 millimeters if we're looking at a full frame equivalent. It can do 4K video up to 30 frames per second. It has a 5-axis stabilization, 20.3 megapixels, a flip up screen. It can shoot 10 frames per second for stills, and all this for a tiny camera that only weighs around 300 grams. But as always, we're gonna divide this video in several sections. The first section will be all about the build quality. So this little compact camera really feels nice in the hand. It feels very solid. I like the way the buttons are feeling. It doesn't feel very cheap at all. And overall, the build quality and how it looks and feels is just really good. But I do wish that the flip up screen had a touchscreen as well, and that the colors were a little bit better. But then again, what can you expect for this kind of price range? This will cost you here in the Netherlands around the 350 euros. The other thing that I really like about this camera is that we have on the left side a little built-in flash that can be very handy in those lower light conditions. At the other side, we got the HDMI and USB-A inputs or IOs. At the bottom, we have the battery and the SD card slot. But the only unfortunate thing is that if you have a tripod and you want to switch out the batteries or the SD card, then you will need to remove the tripod first and then you can replace it. At the top of the camera, we have the on and off button, we have a zoom range trigger, and then the mode dial and a record button. And then at the back, of course, the LCD screen and then the little buttons itself that are very responsive. We also have a little microphone and speaker at the top of this camera. So in overall, the build quality of this camera is actually pretty good. If I have to give it a number, it will be something like a 8 out of 10. All right, let's talk about some more interesting stuff, because this was a little bit boring. Let's talk about the image quality for both photo and for video. And the images what you're seeing right now are straight out of camera on the left side. And on the right side, we have the edited photos. And as you see, there is a huge difference, right? Keep in mind that this camera cannot shoot in RAW. It can only shoot in JPEG, so it will limit your flexibility, which I personally don't really like. But you know, if you hit the exposure correctly and also the composition, then you can actually get some pretty decent images. But from my standpoint and from with my experience, I can work with it. But if you're not an experienced photographer or a photo editor, then you might have a bad time. And the reason for that is because the images straight out of camera, they really look like a smartphone type of quality. If you know what I mean, right? Here's a little comparison between a smartphone and this little Canon PowerShot camera, and as you see, it looks pretty much identical. If you shoot in direct sunlight, you will experience some bad flaring. As you see right here, the flaring is just very visible, right? You cannot escape it, you cannot delete it, you cannot mask it or anything. It's just there, it's just present. And also for video, you can see the same thing as well. Later on in this video, I'm gonna show you the example, but there you will also see some huge flaring that can be very distracting and also very strange looking. So in overall, the image quality for photos, I don't personally really like it, but I can imagine that if you're taking this camera for, let's say, on a summer vacation or anything, or to a tropical island or something, then the image quality will be pretty fine. But honestly, you can also use your smartphone. And when we talk about video, we can also see the same thing, right? So here is a 4K clip on your smartphone. It may look pretty good, right? On a smaller screen, it may look pretty good, but on a larger screen, especially if you watch YouTube on your TV or on a monitor or even on your laptop, you can definitely tell that this little camera is very like limited, right? It's not video oriented at all. And I think that you need to have some kind of expectations with this camera. The video stabilization is actually pretty good as well. As you see here, it has 5-axis stabilization and actually works pretty good. But so unfortunately that the image quality is not that great, but it can be helpful from time to time. If you are using this just to take some little clips, little shots, then it will be perfectly fine. But if you want to do some vlogging and I want to do some real high quality stuff, then this is not it for you. Also, you can do 1080p up to 60 frames per second, but here again, it really looks like a smartphone, and sometimes even worse than a smartphone. So what about the image quality when it comes down to the different range types, right? So at the far end or the long end, it depends how you look at it. Let's say on the 24 millimeter side of things, it looks pretty decent, looks okay, right? From what it can do, looks pretty good. But if you look at it from like the nearest end or the furthest focal length, it is really mushy and really strange looking. It doesn't look sharp at all. And even though it can be very helpful from time to time, I guess, you know, for being a lazy person, then you can just stand at one point and just direct to something, then it can be very helpful. But in general, the image quality of this camera is not that good. Let's talk about the overall performance. As I mentioned, it is a easy to use camera. Like, you can just put it in auto, just leave it on auto, and then it will do everything automatically. You can just share your images quite fast as well. The battery performance of this camera is actually pretty good. I've used this now for the past 2 days, just for recording a little bit of video clips and taking a bunch of photos, and still the battery is full somehow. So I do think that the battery is really good, even though the battery is really small. I do want to mention that if you want to get the best out of your battery, then you need to disable the Bluetooth and disable the Wi-Fi of this camera. The autofocus performance of this camera is not the greatest. It will be a hit or miss sometimes, but in general, like 70%, 80% maybe, it will just hit the mark, hit the spot, and then it will be fine. So for me as a professional, this will not be it, but for an amateur, this will be just fine. The flip up screen is actually really helpful if needed. You can just look at yourself and just frame the shot, and you're good to go. But unfortunately, it's not a touchscreen again. If you want to change the settings, you still need to check out the camera at the back. Okay, so let's wrap this little review up. And overall, as you can already tell, I don't really like this camera when it comes down to the image quality, but I can imagine that for somebody that is on a tight budget, that wants to have like a very easy camera to start with and just have a little camera to bring with all the time, then this Canon PowerShot SX740HS might be something worth checking. But for me, honestly, from a professional standpoint, and I really needed a point and shoot camera, I either use my phone or check a higher end camera such as the Sony ZV-E10 or something else. All right, that's it for this video. Thank you again for watching. Subscribe to the channel if not already. Like the video, comment down below. What do you think about this camera? Do you like it? Do you own it? Let me know in the comment section down below. As always, stay safe, stay healthy. As you notice, my voice is a little bit different than usual because I'm now infected with COVID, but feeling pretty fine. All right, that's it. See you. Ciao.
Test. Can you hear me loud and clear? Or maybe not.